You know, drummers have always been a big influence on the way I've played guitar since 1971 when I began to play. 1969, I heard Tony Oxley on John McLaughlin's Extrapolation album. Then I got the Baptized Traveler album of his own with Derek Bailey, one of the first Derek Bailey records I heard, and many other recordings with him and Derek Bailey. He was a master at combining electronics with drums, probably the supreme master of that. He used ring modulation a lot, which is an effect I like. I'll play a solo for him.
When I first started exploring this music in the early 1990s, two of the most important groups were the Field Trio with Cecil Taylor, William Parker, and Tony Oxley, and Vade Mecum with Bill Dixon's Vade Mecum with Barry Guy, William Parker, and Tony Oxley. And Tony Oxley sort of provided this last bit of information for Bill Dixon's music to be complete. And I think that music is really important and it had a big influence on the way that I think of things orchestrally.
In the mid-1970s, it was the work of Tony Oxley, along with Frank Perry and Paul Burwell, that demonstrated that solo percussion playing was a viable approach to improvised music and helped to define my own contributions to the genre. Tony's playing, in particular, with its incorporation of live electronics, was particularly far-reaching.
This video is for Tony Oxley, who recently passed, an amazing, innovative percussionist, drummer from Britain. Played with Cecil Taylor, Bill Dixon, you name it. Just an international improviser, an amazing player, and truly one of a kind. So this is for him.
Tony Oxley, his legacy is strong. What he's done for the drum set and for percussion is, you know, far-reaching, extended, whatever you want to call it. A friend of mine made this after seeing a video of Tony Oxley, saw that big bill, and he's like, man, I have to do this friend of mine, Greg Keplinger, drum maker. And back here it says, Tony Oxley inspired. It's etched in because he was just like that. So I'm going to play a little bit. Thank you.
In the 80s, when I was a teenager, I was a big fan of the most aggressive, fast, free jazz drummers from the 60s and 70s. People like Rashid Ali, Beaver Harris, Sonny Murray, these kinds of drummers. But the European drummers were a little more elusive. In 1991, I first heard Tony Oxley on the FMP record Looking by the Field Trio. And that blew my mind because this sort of approach to density and speed was upped a few more notches on this record. Oxley's sound was like a very detailed hailstorm of momentum. And I really liked the dry, short tones that he used. That was how he could keep that momentum and still keep enough transparency for the rest of the people to be able to express themselves. It was a huge influence on me. It was almost like free jazz put through the filter of Xenakis stochastics. And big influence on me, especially at one point I dispensed with the snare drum in my free jazz drumming, and he was a big factor in that. So to this day, he lurks in my drumming, but now I'm going to do more of a direct tribute with sounds that I think evoke this Field Trio record and his playing on it.